started Ayah on pureed solids at 4 months, and now she's approaching the six month mark, and I'm gonna introduce her to baby led weaning. Hence why Brandi Milloy is here. Her daughter Millie is 11 months old, and you've introduced baby led weaning to her at 6 months.
Absolutely.
She's gonna teach us what it is, what not to be afraid of, and the foods that you could use while baby led weaning.
Absolutely. I'm so excited that you're at that point, because it means your baby's
excited and nervous. So let's get to it.
So baby-led weaning actually isn't weaning your baby off of formula or breast milk. It's encouraging them to start eating just like you and I.
Yeah.
It encourages hand-eye coordination. They learn how to feed themselves. And really, there's not a lot of studies that say you have to give your baby pureed foods by a spoon and force them to eat. Mm-hmm. I love this approach because it makes food fun. And it teaches them how to eat just like us.
And that's the thing, what I've been reading a lot about is when you're sitting down having dinner, your baby should be having dinner with you.
Yes.
So, and now I've noticed it in Ayah, when we're eating, she's actually curious and she's staring at us like this, like, what are they doing?
I love that, yeah.
That's when I know she's ready.
Yes, exactly, yes. Some of the signs you can look for to know if your baby's ready is they should be 6 months. Mm-hmm. Anything younger than that, their digestion isn't developed yet and they're not really ready. They should be able to sit up on their own.
Yeah.
They should show curiosity and try to be engaged in mealtime. And also, they should know how to use their pointer finger and their thumb a little bit so they can actually pick up the food themselves. And they don't have to have teeth. You know, Millie started doing baby-led weaning with just one tooth, but it teaches them how to chew and swallow and use different reflexes. I'm coming. Oh,
so, okay, number one question, are they gonna choke? Is there a risk of choking?
So, choking is different than gagging,
okay.
Right? So choking is, there is something blocking their airways, you need to help them, and that's why all moms should know CPR.
Yes.
But also, the gagging is a reflex. I mean, that's a natural reflex, and that's teaching them how to chew and swallow the right way. You should never leave your baby unattended when you're encouraging the solid foods. But yeah, don't be scared. Millie actually hasn't had any really big gagging fits or no choking at all. And I think a lot of it starts with the prep. So when you're going to introduce solids to your baby, you should start with all soft foods.
Mm-hmm.
Steamed vegetables. I love doing steamed sweet potatoes, steamed broccoli. If you can pinch it between your finger and thumb, it's good for baby.
It's basically like it dissolves in their mouth. So chewing is not really a factor because since they don't have teeth.
Yeah, and they're learning how to use their little gums. It's so funny. She would look like a little grandma, like,
yeah, you
know, just like chewing and trying. But it's the mechanics. It's honestly, it's nothing to be afraid of.
I've seen a lot of the fruits and vegetables when they're introducing baby-led weaning. What about the proteins like salmon, beef, chicken? Is that okay?
Yeah, actually, Millie's one of her favorite foods is salmon, and we used shredded chicken, ground turkey, ground beef. You just want to make sure that it's soft.
Okay.
We started introducing proteins around 8 months, once we knew she really had the mechanics of eating. But I mean, what I love about baby-led is that when we go to dinners and out to eat at restaurants,
you're not sitting there feeding her, she's feeding herself.
No, and I can find something on the menu that she can enjoy. And I love that her palate is developing.
Yeah.
I mean, this girl loves guacamole with jalapenos. She really loves everything.
Like she's dancing, she's like, yeah!
You know, and it's given her so much self-confidence and independence because she's learning about textures and taste. And when she's full, she tells us.
Yeah.
And you know, I've seen her hang out with some of her other baby friends, and a lot of them, you know, kind of still hit the food and smash because they don't really
know. They're not used to it.
Yeah, they're not used to it. So I do love this approach, and I think that it's something that every parent shouldn't be afraid of, for sure. One thing I love about baby-led weaning is it's introduced new foods that I haven't eaten in a while. Like, she loves winter squash, so now I'm going to the grocery store trying to get different produces. But going back to tips, I think making it fun. You know, if they're a little older, cutting the foods into fun little shapes.
Yeah.
Making sure that it's, you know, a fun experience, not like you have to eat the rest of this. I think the biggest thing to making it fun is incorporating it into your mealtime. Mm-hmm. Everyone in the family sitting together, even your four-legged pet, you know, everyone's eating, we're having fun. There's no pressure to finish everything, and I think that really develops really healthy habits later on.
Yeah, I agree.
Another concern that parents might have are allergies.
Yes.
Because, I mean, that is so stressful. Like, what if they're allergic? I think the biggest thing is there's been so many studies that suggest that the earlier you incorporate those high allergen foods like egg and seafood and peanut butter, the less of a chance that they're actually gonna develop an allergy. My pediatrician said, you know, if someone in your immediate family has that allergy, talk to your doctor first.
Yeah.
But what I love is we incorporated peanut butter early on, eggs, dairy, seafood, and so far, all things are good. So if anyone has any hesitations, talk to your doctor first, but do
honestly,
know
honestly, at your 4-month checkup, ask your doctor, but before I even asked, when I went to her 4-month checkup, she said, introduce everything. Just have that baby Benadryl with you just in case. But introduce everything.
Yes, yeah, because that is so hard. I have a girlfriend whose kid is allergic to everything, and it's so hard.
Yeah, it is really, really hard.
And it's really scary.
All right, Brandi, this was super, super helpful. What are the top 3 tips that you would give anyone that's gonna start on baby-led weaning?
Well, when it comes to baby-led weaning, don't be scared. This is... it's natural, it's awesome, it's really fun, and honestly, it's gonna make your life easier because she can eat at the big girl table, just like you. Mm-hmm. Number 2 is make sure that the foods are soft and that they can pick them up. Oh, you want some more food? And number 3 is just have fun. You know, it's gonna be messy. There's gonna be food everywhere. They might not like certain things, but it's so fun.
Speaking of messy, I'm already preparing for Aya's messiness. And I just found this brand, Bumpkins.
How cool is this?
Yeah, it's a bib shirt because the bibs get messy and they stain, and I get anxiety when things stain. So this is perfect, you guys.
That is amazing. I need to get one of those for little Miss Millie.
You like this, huh?
I love that. We gotta get you one of those. I also love the Easy Peasy mat because it sticks to a lot of high chairs. And then it's great because sometimes I bring food with me to restaurants already in a little dish. So
yeah, it's already ready.
Yeah, you really don't need that much. You know, just have fun.
Yeah, have fun. All right, this was super helpful for me.
You got this, Mama.
As I'm starting the process of solids. If you guys have any other questions, leave it in the comments below. And if you want more information on baby-led weaning, what it is, some recipes, head to Brandi's website, BrandiMilloy.com. And if you want to see our collaboration, head to her channel.
Yes, that was so much fun.
Bye.
Say bye. I got a full belly now. Bye.
Nap time.